There we go.
This is the back area where we did the baking. Something like something. Guess I need some new ones, but I can see all right. Her husband wanted her to retire, and she's around 66, 67, and my other sister, she worked in a decorating room, and her husband wanted her to retire, so I'm 66 now, or 65 right now, and it was just time to get out, you know. We've been since for sale for a couple years now. I've been trying to sell the business, and nobody wanted to work that hard anymore. And right now, we're probably going to start auctioning everything off. And then just sell the building.
And this is just the back room where we had storage and a couple of walk-in freezers back here, one there and one here. This is the main one we use. That there is a dough rounder, like rounds up the dough in little balls, like if you were making sandwich buns and stuffing, or it divides the dough in 36 pieces. That's a sheeter that, both of these machines here are sheeted where you roll your dough and you fold in your sharpening it, or roll your piece of dough out. This is a bread maker and you roll your dough through here and put your dough in your molds. And you cut donuts out and all kinds of different things like that with that. That machine there is older than I am. That's got to be at least 75 years old, at least.
I'm a cookie depositor that cuts, puts your cookies on the trays.
You put your dough on the top and then put your guillotine right here that cuts the dough, slices the dough, and lays it right on the pan.
Well, that's not really a clock. What it is, it's
how many shelves are in the oven. So every time you say you put something in number one, you know, and when you want something to come around, you can see it going around. So when you're looking for something in number one, it'll come up, and or whatever number you're on. But this is number four, so if you're doing something, waiting, doing something, and you got something number four, you can see, kind of know when to come over here and look and see what if it's done or not, or whatever, you know. Or if you're loading like a set of cookies or something like that, started on number four, you put it in, so when you know when the time when the cookies are about done, you know what number you started on, where to start pulling first. You know, that's the idea of it.
And this is a proof box that you can put actually up to four racks into it and proof your dough, like, you know, sweet dough or Danish dough or your breads or whatever you have. And you can put them right into this oven here, what they call a rack oven.
It's a dying breed. There's only about four bakeries left in St. Louis. Butterhoffers, Helfers, Missouri Bakery. There's one on Arnold. I think it's Arnold. But yeah, there used to be a lot of them, but they're... Your bakeries now are like St. Louis Bread or... I mean, there's no hardly any scratch bakeries anymore. Everything bagged. So you get people... Then just add water and oil or whatever, you know, to make the mix, and you're done. And a lot of stuff comes prepared. I mean, you can buy your Danish dough and your puff pastry dough or whatever. You know, you got to roll it out and make it up. And you know, all the stuff that takes a lot of time to make is gone almost. And, you know, and cut off is one of the last ones around. That's about as old as I am, too, that one there. My dad started in 1937. My mom and dad met, well, before that, they met in Kirkwood Bakery. And my dad was a baker, my mom was a store girl, and they got hooked up. And my dad wanted a raise, 25-cent raise, and the guy wouldn't give it to him. So my mom and my dad, after they got married, decided to start their own place. And they started down at Christie and King's Highway down there. And they were there for a long time. And it was kind of dangerous for the kids. I think we only had one or two kids. My mom and dad only had one or two kids at that time. And it was a little dangerous down there because of King's Highway. So they decided to open a bakery up in Maplewood. So they moved up into Maplewood, and they were there for a long time, and business was good, and there's a new shopping center was opening up. I can't give the correct date, but Watson Road was still a gravel road. And they were in the Bill Yarchar Shopping Center, and my dad thought that would be a good place to go. And my dad counseled, no, you shouldn't do it, you're gonna lose, there's nothing out there. But he decided to go there as a second store, and finally, as it started prospering, my dad moved the whole bakery down to Yorkshire, and he moved down there two or three different times. He was down at the end, then he was up, finally end up in the middle where I don't know if you remember, there used to be an IGA store there. Well, he was right next to the IGA store. And then when my sister and I both got out of high school and that, back in around the 70s, we started working there full time. And my dad wanted to get out, so we decided to take it over from my parents.
And up around 78 or so, we bought this building because it was for sale. And we moved up here, and we've been up here for about 30 years. So, and we both, you know, decided it's time to close it out. Like I said, my son was going to take it over, but my sister was just kind of a little hard to work with. You know, she was just back stuck in the 70s, and my son had a lot of different ideas, you know, as younger kids do, doing different things. We did have a couple of things that were going real good, but just too many heads clashing together, and he decided to go a different route, and he's probably doing better where he's at now, but it was time to close up, and we were trying to sell. We had one or two buyers, but we were afraid. None of them really were bakers or anything like that. They just wanted it, and we were kind of afraid to sell our name to them and ruin our name, because they really didn't, neither one of them really had any bakery sense, you know, and they didn't really know what really it takes to run a bakery. I mean, not only you have to know how to bake and do all that, you got to take care of the business and run the business, pay the taxes, or whatever.
That room, kind of messy, but it's the decorating room.
Where we did all our decorating back there, and
put cakes on the shelf there. And kind of messy. That's the office, more or less. It's funny, when I'm up here, if I come up here and cars in front, people still pull in. Oh, they're open. Oh. A lot of people don't know we're closed. They know when they come up.
The last 2 weeks, we had people lined up to the street waiting to get in at 5 o'clock in the morning. We weren't open yet. Every day, people wanted to buy, like, we were kind of famous for gooey butters, and people wanted to buy 10, 15 at a time so they could put it in their freezer, you know? And, you know, we just had a limit of so many, we can only make so many at a time, and
it's come out.
I mean, she's around 40 there. If there's a date on here or not. No, no date.
And here's one of my mom. But she passed away in one. She was 101. She couldn't do it mentally. She could wanted to be here every day, and this was her life. Stacks and stacks of letters, and Facebook, we got stacked up stuff like that from Facebook people. And then we were with that on Riverfront Times, the best bakery and the best of St. Louis. A couple pictures of some old bakers. That's just a picture somebody made for us. And this is my sister's daughter. We got Mary, we made her a wedding cake. That was one of our big business, doing wedding cakes. Things are changing there too. They're going to, like, you know, they have a small wedding cake to show, and then they get sheet cakes and stuff like that. Or they do cupcakes instead, or, you know, cut down the cost. And we added this on
15 years ago, this area can sit down with wedding cakes and few people can eat here when I had the deli. We used to ship stuff all over the place. We had a website. People that used to live here, live out in California, some are green butters and stuff like that, and ship them.
We're going to try to sell some of the stuff online first and see if we can get a little higher price on some of the stuff, you know.